This is a open split core, so the core has already been split, and because the core has been split, the faces in the upper part of the core are nice and flat, okay? And one of the things we want to do is we want to get a better understanding of how cores are related to the pictures that we see and that we make with seismic images. So the seismic images are made with sound, essentially sound waves, sort of similar to sound waves. And what we want to do is want to see how fast sound goes through the rocks, because sometimes sound goes through very slowly, sometimes it goes through very fast. And what we can do is through an individual site, we can look at how the seismic velocity varies depth. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this this core, and we're going to measure individual pieces and the seismic or the sonic velocity inside the individual pieces. And what we'll do, we'll just put this lad wrap that we're going to put on it. We just put it on top of the rock, and we're going to put a little piece of water on there. And that water increases the coupling between the transducer and the surface of the sample. What you'll do is we're going to close the two transducers there. We'll bring it down. So now you see we're closing the two transducers, and they've come together. We have the an image of the arrival of the sonic wave as it's going through, and what we see here is it's going to be, it may be done automatically or maybe not. We'll see with the computer. There's another little view of it, and it measured the velocity. So here, this is a pulse of sound wave. It goes through, and we've made thousands and thousands of measurements within just a moment's time, and then they've been all compressed together. And we can see a little pulse here. It's sort of like the first thump. You can imagine that goes through the sample. And it looks like the computer made a good pick, and it picked the velocity out of 2140 meters per second. And so that's a bit faster than water. Through water, it goes through at 1500 meters per second. And it's very common for the kind of sediments that we're looking at. And then what we do here is we'll just now save that value.